I need more fumes. Damn it. What can I do? Wait. Batteries.
What a dick. Anyway, looking back at my videos, the one that's had the most sort of interaction and views so far is the one with the Ultrafire batteries, the crap quality batteries off eBay and the like. And I suppose that makes sense, you know, a lot of people are using them in different hobbies and activities now. When I done the video, I was just looking at it from an airsoft perspective because I use them in torches and flashlights. But I wanted to do another video because there are good batteries out there too. So I got on eBay and I got some good 30Q Samsung batteries. I bought them from Torchy the battery boy. He's by no means going to be the only person selling decent batteries, but he's a name that kept coming up again and again when I was chatting about them. So got a couple of those. Let's get them unboxed. We'll give them the charging test that I done in the previous video with the Ultrafires and see how they compare. So this is how they arrive in a Torchy branded box. They come inside a plastic case for protecting the batteries, and the batteries themselves have been covered in a Torchy branded wrapper. Now the amperage quoted on there is 30 amps, I'll come back to that. Now it's already been discharged the same way I discharge all the batteries, and the charger is, it doesn't discharge the batteries right down to 2.5 volts, which I think is what the manufacturers use. It only goes down to 3.2, I believe. And that's to protect the battery, because the batteries aren't meant to be over-discharged or overcharged. It'll kill a lithium ion cell quicker than anything else. So what you'll see when it charges is you won't see the full 3000 milliamp hour, which is a quoted capacity, because it's not flattened the battery right down or charging it right up to the very top that the manufacturers would have done in order to quote that capacity and see that capacity. So, obviously a very basic test, and the charger does take the battery over a much more limited range, as I've said a couple of times. But to get 2200 milliamp hours out the Torchy Samsung battery does make the 3000 milliamp hour label claim very believable. And then when you contrast that against the Ultrafire, which the label claims 4200 milliamp hours, it's over a third higher than what the Samsung claims. Yet it gets, you know, 167 milliamp hours into it over the same range. And, you know, it just goes to show how terrible the cheap batteries are. Now, the Ultrafires, you can get them on eBay for $3.99 a pair delivered. And that's what's drawing people in, is that cheap price. And I touched on that in the previous video. The Torchy, they were more expensive, but they were $13.99, I believe, delivered. And I don't think that's too expensive. I mean, I think to get decent ones, you're going to have to pay maybe £10 a pair as a minimum. So at $13.99 with the case, with the support you get for Torchy, I think they're very good batteries, and certainly a lot better than the Ultrafire ones. Coming back to that current rating that Torchy puts on there, he puts 30 amps on the wrapper. And I think Samsung specs them at 15 amps. They themselves have tested them at 20 amps. Now, I asked Torchy about this and he gave me a message back, and I'm going to read that message out. I'll put it on the screen for you as well. So he says, the industry standard was set when 10 amps was considered high drain, and the battery rating was set at the current at which the battery maintains 70% capacity. Manufacturers seem to do their own things these days. Samsung rate their batteries based on the current at which they maintain 70% capacity over 300 charge and discharge cycles. They do show graphs up to 20 amps, constant current on their data sheet, and they maintain around 95% capacity. That's at 20 amps, they retain 95. They only need to retain 70 for the spec. So, real world, what does that mean? Well, what I read from that message is that the batteries were spec'd at a time where 10 amps was high drain. They didn't really need to prove them far beyond that point. but they did go up to 20 amps in their own spec sheet. So they were basically saying, you know, this battery can do double what AMD needs it to do just now. It's good to go. But since then, with Torchy's own tests and on his graphs, you can see that he's pushed them a good bit further. He tests them up to 40 amps. He told me in another message he'd even pulse tested them to 60 amps. The battery survived. Now, if you're only using flashlights, they're low current draw devices. It's not going to matter. You're only interested in the capacity and how long the light's going to last. For vaping, well, a lot of people are stuck on, you know, their 15 amp batteries. Well, they can be pushed. These are one of the quality batteries that you can push a little bit further. So what I plan to do is, in the future, build a separate battery station with a remote vaping rig, because I started vaping myself after the last battery video. Oh, I'm alright, that was meant to happen. And that'll allow me to test these batteries to destruction. Now, I don't have the budget to go destroying perfectly good batteries right at this moment, but moving forward, that's where we'll go with that. Flood the bus, it's absolutely freezing in here. Tried to do a full video without the jacket and it's just not happening. Scotland in February, and according to the news, we're meant to be getting 6 inches of snow tonight. The missus says that'll be the first time she's had 6 inches in a long time. 6.5! Anyway, to round off, I wanted to make this video because it was a sort of balance for the first battery video I'd done. You know, there are good batteries and good vendors out there. Torchy's just one, and hopefully I'll get a chance to look at others in the future. But it comes back to what I said in the first video, really. If the batteries are too cheap and they're making ridiculous claims on the label, they're going to be terrible. So just avoid, you know, pay a little bit more. You'll get a battery that does what you expect it to do. It'll have the capacity it claims, and it'll be safer as well. I mean, I explained some of the dangers in that first video. It's just not worth taking the risk. So I'll leave it there, and I hope, as usual, this has been useful to somebody. If it has been, please hit the like button, maybe even subscribe to the channel, and I'll catch you in the next one.